Hey everybody, it is Cameron back with a sales update video. This is for the month of July. I'm only about 13 days late on this one, so not as bad as usual, but I did do pretty well this month. Was out of town for probably 4 or 5 days at the end of the month for my brother's wedding, so we still were a little short on days of sales like we were in June, but still managed to be at 33, 11, 42. As you can see, a pretty big jump over June. The goal this year was to average 3,000 per month. We've hit that 2 or 3 months so far. Not that great, and it was a pretty lofty goal because I was only at about 2,300 or 2,400 last year. So that's an extra $600 a month, hoping to net and sa or gross in sales. But we did it this month, so that was pretty awesome. Looking down here, you can see there were quite a few things in the high numbers of 150 or 115, 189. That's what we were trying to do, is get a couple more sales that are higher up. That really helps the numbers. We're always going to have the $15, $20 ones, but we need to find more stuff that's a little bit bigger and better. I ended up selling 117 things this month, and if you average that out, it's about $28.30 is your sale price. Keep in mind, you may have heard that. I guess I just sold something. Yeah, I sold something. That's pretty cool. So, with respect to my average sale being $28.30, that also includes free shipping. So obviously, all my items, most of my items are going to be with free shipping. So I'm averaging about $28.38 ship, which is pretty good. I'd like to be averaging about 30. I'm still going to sell stuff that's going to be 8, 10, 12, 15, depending on what it is. So I'm going to have stuff that's lower than that. I'm just hoping I'm having enough bigger stuff that kind of brings the average up. So let's go ahead and jump in. Whoops. Wrong thing. So hopefully, I'm going to move that so you guys can see. There. So this is the first thing. When I copied the picture, you can see I accidentally highlighted everything, so it looks a little janky, but these TI-84 calculators, I was trying to buy up as many as I could going into the school year. I actually have one to pick up this week. I paid 20 bucks for this one, I believe, or 25. I sold it for 68. Now that's not that's pretty high amount to put into a calculator like this. I mean, most people don't want to spend 25 into 68. I've been doing it because as long as it works, which I test at the place, I know I can sell it for this amount. And I can walk away with 20, 25, 30 bucks of profit. And it's an easy, quick sale. So I know some people need better margins than that, but for me, I'm trying to find some of those bigger numbers. And even though I'm not, my ROI on the initial investment isn't as high as, say, paying a dollar into 20, I'm actually getting still more money back profit-wise. So I've been trying to do that as well, and it has been working. So that was that. This was a little microphone I picked up, or a little handset I picked up at a garage sale for $3. Sold it for 40. Didn't know if it worked or not. It sold within a couple of days for 40 bucks. The brand Shure, this is a good brand to look for. So if you find anything from them, definitely look at it, try to look it up. Obviously, if you're in that kind of industry and know that stuff, you know it's valuable. But yeah, 40 bucks there for a $3 investment. Here we are with some Christian like animated DVDs. I picked these up at a Salvation Army for $2 each, I believe. So 22 bucks. Sold them for $80. Again, spent a little bit more on them. Don't really want to pay $2 for a DVD, but I ended up getting 80 bucks, so that was pretty cool. Not the best picture, but a Cutco spatula. This one actually had a business engraved on here. It was like an attorney, I think, his name and his phone number. Paid $5 for this at an estate sale. It was, I think, 10, and they wanted half off 5. Sold it for 27 though. If you don't know the name Cutco, I've sold them a bunch of times. Look them up, look for their stuff. If you're at an estate sale, especially, look to see if you'll start recognizing these handles. They have a couple different kinds. There's like a white one, there's this brown one, and a black one, I think, and there's also a couple of different models too, but look them up because Cutco stuff sells super well. Xenosaga, this is from a big PS2 lot we had. I paid 100 bucks for a bunch of PS2 games, PS1 games, and some DVDs. This alone sold for 85, just 3 games, so that was good. This is something funny. I bought a box of Briar Horses. I found this little doll in there. Didn't have the hat. Her hair was all kind of jacked up. but sold it for $9. So pretty cool if you can just kind of pull something you didn't realize when you buy a lot of stuff that you had in there, and then you can turn around and make some extra money. Not a ton, but oops, not a ton, but still pretty cool. Griswold, this is a cast iron skillet. It was all messed up. I didn't take the time to clean it. Next time, I think I will, just to see if it makes a big difference. I know there's a couple of different solutions to clean them. I want to see if it makes a difference and if it's worth it. So I had paid $5 for this and sold it for 35. It shipped in a, I think, a regional rate, or no, a smart post for $11. So we didn't do too bad there. Griswold, good name to look out for in cast iron. Also, Wagnerware does pretty well, usually not as well as Griswold, but and it really depends on what number it is or what style. Different ones do a lot better than others. So, Game Boy, bought this Game Boy with a Super Nintendo for, and in the box, a Super Nintendo. I paid $100 for everything, and it came with a Super Game Boy, a couple of extra Super Nintendo games, and this, and another Game Boy game in the case. Sold this one for $32, so that was pretty good. Polaroid, these are my go-tos. Here's one for 25. Honestly, I usually get 28. I used to get 30. Haven't bought the 30 ones. I dropped it down to 25 just to make a quick sale at the beginning of the month. But now I've sold some since then. I'm getting about 28. So there's 25 there. Same person bought this one for 25. Easy money. If I sell one by itself, I padded flat rate them in a envelope. So wrap them in a little bit of bubble wrap, throw them in an envelope, ship them there. I've never had a complaint from the guy. Actually, I've always gotten positive feedback. I've even communicated with them in Messenger, and they're happy with everything that I'm doing. I've also, if I sell two, I'll wrap them up and then put them in like a medium flat rate. It's about the same as paying for two padded envelopes, so a little bit cheaper, I think. Video games, my one of my other favorites. A little paid 50 cents or a dollar for this, I think, at $11. This one was actually got a returner. I had to refund them. Found this in a box of toys I had bought for a dollar. It looked in great shape. Plugged it in. You know, I didn't have a battery to actually test it. I sold it for $12. The lady said it didn't work. So kind of took a chance on that one because it looked like it was in really good shape, but I didn't have a battery to test it. Who knows if it actually didn't work or not, but either way, that one was kind of a cancellation there, so not so great. Sony Walkman, paid $7 for this at a garage sale. It did work pretty well. Sold it for $43. I did say that when it had the radio worked well, the cassette was a little bit off, which I put in the description. I could hear it, but it wasn't as clear as the AM/FM radio. Still got $43 for that, so awesome. An old listing here, HP Ink, paid a dollar for this at a garage sale, sold it for 15. Took a while, but it finally sold. But I don't do those pictures anymore, so those look pretty crappy. NHL Starter, paid five, three or $5 for this at an older 55 plus community, like a manufactured homes area. And I walked up to the sale expecting to find, like, not this, not an Anaheim Ducks hoodie. But did the lady said she it was hers. She loves the Ducks, but she just doesn't wear it anymore. I sold this for $35 and got good feedback, so that was awesome. Oh, and it did go global shipping program, so that was even cooler. And then I sold this right after that. I paid $12 for this at Savers. It's a starter Mets jacket. This is an older one. The '90s one looks a little different. So this one I think is from the '80s. Or early '90s, but I sold it for $90. It was a guy, he had never had any feedback with his brand new account. I know people get scared to ship into them. I sold a $90 thing to somebody and he got it and didn't give me feedback on it, but no issues, no complaints. So just because someone's brand new doesn't mean that they it's going to be a problem, especially with even a higher end item. And this guy, what I imagine, was on Google, was searching for Met stuff, or somehow my listing came up. He clicked it, made an account as a guest, and bought. So pretty awesome there. Here's some thematic units, different things for teachers. I paid 60 cents each for these, so it's $7.20, something like that. Sold them for 30. I get six, my books at Goodwill are 60 cents, so depending on which ones I want to buy, sometimes I'll buy a lot of stuff. Bought these, and since they're going to ship me an email, wasn't too bad. Nerf, these are clips that you can hook on the orange little ammo magazines to. I always get $10 for a lot of two of these, so if you find them or you buy some Nerf stuff, you can part out just this part and get $10, so pretty cool. Next. This game I took an offer on, 22.50. I had paid 50 cents for this. It's like a little electronic game. It did work. I have no idea really how to play though. I was not successful from the sounds that it was making as I was playing, but someone bought it from Texas, knew what it was, and gave me good feedback. So awesome there. Koi Scrubs. The Koi is a great brand for scrubs. These are the pants, and they were a size 2XL, which is like really, really great. Sold these for $16. I had bought them in a box of scrubs for $5. I had bought like 100 different pieces of different brand scrubs at a rummage sale at my mother-in-law's school, and paid $5, and I made a ton of money off that stuff. And this was one of the last things for $16. UFC DVDs, paid $10 for all these. Ended up selling them for $43. Took a little while. I was hoping to get more like 50, but it just wasn't there. But eventually, someone came through and bought them all, and they shipped me in mail, so super easy. You can even see one of them is kind of cracked right there, so that wasn't a deal breaker. This is a Nike kind of tennis polo from the 90s. There is a line of ones that are Andre Agassi. You type in Nike Agassi polos or dry fit or something, you'll see what I'm talking about. Some of those do really well. This one kind of looks like that. It's not one of the really nice ones, but I had paid $4 or $5 for this at Savers. I got sold it for $40, and I think it went global shipping program too. So that was good. Pokemon Master Trainer. Look up these games. I sold the earlier Master Trainer for $95 the other day, and I had paid 10 for that. This one was not complete. I had paid 5 or 10 for this. I sold it for 40, and it was missing quite a bit of pieces. And the box was beat up. One of the corners was coming loose. So even pretty good deal for $40. Oops. These little Braun replacement blades. I got this one for like 50 cents or so. If you factored out in a lot that I had bought, sold it for $21. I've sold three of these probably so far, and I usually get 18 to 22. So if you see these, pick them up, and if you could buy a bunch of them, that'd be awesome. I'd love to find like someone who stockpiled these or hoarded them, and then I could sell, just have one listing and sell off a bunch over time. Another PS2 game, $12 there, so nothing too crazy. Nintendo console. This one I had bought for $10 with some other stuff. Didn't have all the cords for it. Technically, I probably have enough in my storage to make the system work, but didn't want to waste the time. Didn't want to have to replace the 72-pin connector in there to make sure the games work every time. You don't have to, but it really is better if you're gonna sell it. So I just sold it for parts for $40. It ships for about $10 or so, SmartPost, depending on where it's going, and not too bad there. This is how I've been doing the Nintendos. Unless they're in really good shape and I want to mess around and I have all this stuff, but honestly, it's so much easier this way. I think for one that works, you might get $100 for it with a game or with controllers and stuff. So I could sell this for 40, probably sell the power cord for 15 to 20, sell the two controllers with it probably for about 20. I mean, you could almost get the same sale price in a non-working system like I did if you part it all out. So not too bad there. Nintendo games that actually came with a Nintendo that I bought. There's $9 there. These aren't crazy, and I know some people aren't going to want to mess around with these, but I still do with video games because they're easy listings. It's like two or three pictures, ships first class every time, and they sell really quick. Dodgers golf club head covers, paid $5. There's supposed to be a third one in here from what I was told, but got $20 for that. Dodgers are doing really well this year. Mario Party 9. This one was returned. I tested it and it worked. It's a Wii game. It's got some scratching on it, but minor scratching, not even anything serious. Excuse me. But sold it for 30. Guy said it didn't work. He returned it, and I actually haven't even tested it since, and it's sitting in my pile of stuff to go through. So I got it tested. I refunded them. I'm getting about 3 to 5 returns probably a month, maybe a little bit less every once in a while, but returns or stuff, something that may have broke. Usually I get one or two returns on a clothing item, which I have a restocking fee on, so I don't really lose anything on those, and I'm putting all the measurements there, so usually someone bought it just doesn't fit right, which is fine, that's gonna happen. So when I'm getting, like I said, getting that 20% back, I usually rarely get video game returns, but all of a sudden now, oh, my cat's messing with the monitor there. But I've been getting a lot more with the Not a lot more, a few more with the video games. I even had two already this month in August, and it's only 13 days in. So I was surprised. I have been testing them. They're working on my systems. Some of them are a little scratched, but I've sold them before, and as long as I can get them to work. So I don't know what's going on, so I'll have to figure it out. But that's kind of a bummer there. But definitely a good game to look out for on the Wii, one of the better ones. Jumanji, board game. I usually get a minimum of 30 for this. I've gotten as high as 37, I think. You know, with SmartPost, it's going to cost you around $10 to ship it. I had paid like $2 for this. So, Tamagotchis, look for these guys. If you can find Tamagotchis, I bought this in a lot, four of them for $20. Please look for these because they are selling like crazy. People are collecting them. I got $40 for this one. It takes one of those little cell batteries. You can get them dollar store or sometimes, or you can even order them on eBay. And like I said, $40 for a little Tamagotchi keychain. So, food processor parts, I've been selling a lot of those. $10 for this one. Another Tamagotchi from that same lot of $20. Sold that one for $40. Qbert, $12. Pretty good Nintendo game. These are the little video cassettes for Sony. I forgot what I paid for these. Few bucks, I think, and sold them for $26. Another Nintendo game. This one's kind of pretty common. You see it quite often, but it's not worth a whole lot. $8. Nike Dry Fits. Paid $3 for this, three or four. I sell these for 15 usually if they're a size large or extra large. If it's a 2X, I usually can get, somewhere above 15, but less than 20. So I know some people will try to get 20 for the Nike Golfs, and you can. I just sell them for 15 if it's a good pattern because it seems like they sell pretty quick. If you get like this one had a nice striping on it, or you get some kind of design, it seems like you can move them pretty easy. So, a little Game Boy game, Final Fantasy Tactics for 12. Game Boy Advance SP. Another thing that I recommend if you see these, pick them up. I'm usually getting a minimum of probably 38 for a system with the charger. If you don't have a charger, you can order them online, aftermarket ones for $2 or $3 a piece. If you buy them in a lot of like four or five, and it's usually still a good deal. So that's $42 there. And usually these things I find are $5 or $10 at a garage sale. So Turtles in Time from a Super Nintendo lot that I bought, paid 200 for that, for the whole lot. That game for 38, 21 for that game, also from that lot. Expo's hat, $20. Bought this a lot a long time ago, but someone offered me 20. One of his was global shipping as well, but $20, I'm fine with that. I got good feedback. Mario World, also from that lot, $20. Walking Dead, $7. Just got this in a lot of PlayStation stuff I had bought. It was sitting in there, so sold it for $7. Not a big deal. Zelda, also from that Super Nintendo lot, $31. Cuisinart, this is from the best food. Whoops, sorry, the best food processor you can buy is the older one. This is the DLC-8, I think it's called. That one seemed the parts have sold the best on that. $20 just for the blade, so that's pretty awesome. I had paid 10 for the whole unit. So, Advance Wars, $13, sells pretty well. This one was something I bought for $5. I bought it with that Shure microphone we saw in the beginning. I did not sell it for 100. Took a best offer of $50 to someone in New York. Worked at something studio, some I don't know, some audio studio or something it was called. Sold it for 50 and got good feedback, so that was awesome. Another game from that Super Nintendo lot, $24. Another one for 10, just so you can see. Harley's Humongous Adventure, not a great game, but $10. So this for 17 on a best offer, but the guy got it, wore it one day. When he went to take it off, he tried to adjust the snaps, I guess, or something, and snap broke. So it probably was dry rotted a little bit or something. I had undone it and did it for the picture, but maybe he did it with more force, or maybe it being out in the sun, or who knows what. He's a super nice guy. He actually lived in Chicago. He was real disappointed. He showed sent me pictures of it broken. So I just gave him his money back. Unfortunate, but he was super cool. He did give me good feedback on the situation and, just kind of a bummer. That's what happens though. Another game from that lot, 13. NBA Jam, great game, $9. BKE, Carter, these are a brand that they have. These are a smaller size 31. If you can get like 34 plus size with this brand, you can get closer to 30, 35. But this is a smaller size, so got 27 there. Still pretty good. Paid $5. Another game from that lot for 17, the two colored Super Mario. Super awesome. It's a little bit rare to find one that's double color like that, so pretty cool. That was a joke. This paid $5. It's for a like a little muscle stimulator thing. I had paid $5 at a moving sale, and I sold it for $44. Never heard back from the person. It did work. I got it to power up, and I could tell it was working, but I haven't heard back from the person, so I'll assume that they're enjoying the stimulation. A Disney watch here, did not sell it for 35. Found this in that little new bright charger that got a return on. I found this in that box sitting at the bottom. Took a best offer of $20 from Global Shipping Program, someone in Italy, I believe it was. It did not work, but it was I just listed it for 35 and sold it for 20, so super cool. Texas Instruments, another one I paid $20, $15, I don't know, $10, something like that. I don't remember. But met a guy over at a Best Buy near me. He had used this for one class, and he said he's never taken another math class again. So this is the nice TI-84. It's the LED one. Sold it for $85, and it sold within like a day. So that was awesome. Here we are with Super Mario Sunshine. Bought this in a lot. Got $29 for that. Just the disc. Indiana Jones, if you might have seen this in a haul video, paid 15 for this, sold it for 73 in about a day. Had a crease in the box. Probably, I still think I probably should have listed it at $80 though. It sold so fast. Zelda, $39 there. Great GameCube game to buy. A backpack paid 5, sold it for 25. Ships at 2 pounds. I think it cost me like $9 to ship it. But didn't do too well, 16. It's like I probably made like $7 on it, so made a little bit of money, but honestly was hoping I'd get more like 30 for it. So another game from that lot. This guy actually messaged me for a return, said the game wouldn't work. I messaged him that night before bed and said, hey, return it, no problem. Worked for me, sorry about the inconvenience. Next day messaged me and says the game works. Tried it multiple times, no issues, not sure what happened the first time. He didn't clean it. He said it was really clean inside, which I had cleaned it before I sent it out. I do that with all the games, but he goes, I don't know what happened, but it's working fine. No need to return it. So that was kind of cool. Donkey Kong Country, $21. A lot of video games this time. Like a cheerleading thing. I paid a dollar or two for this at Salvation Army. Sold it for 13. Mario Party 6, $42. Actually, there. Hope someone's watching this because someone quoted me in one of my comments that Mario Party 6, I just bought it again. I think I had said it might sell for, pushing towards 50, which is a little bit high. It's probably more like a 45 is your best bet if you're going to get like top dollar, maybe 47. The guy said it was $40 tops in one of my comments, which I appreciate him at least trying to call me out if I made a mistake. Any of you are welcome to. I do my best to try to be accurate, but I am not perfect, so don't. Don't hesitate if you see I made a mistake, feel free to say something. Hopefully respectfully, but if not, that's okay too. I guess he accused me of lying. I then did a little search, confirmed that they do still sell for over 40. I sold one for 42. Some sold for bids for 44, and a couple people got buy it nows for 45, 46, 43. So just so everyone knows, this game does sell for more than $40, despite what some people believe. So anywho, another game, $10, Super Nintendo. Polaroid here, $34. So this did not sell to my usual Polaroid person. I listed a little bit higher because it had the box, but sold to a different person who wanted it. That was pretty awesome. I think I paid $7 for that. So that's pretty good. Cuisinart DLC-8, like I told you, the best. This is just the top chute here, and the lid, $35. Global Shipping Program. These Time Life books paid a dollar for all these. It was at a garage sale looking at the books. The lady goes, "Do you want those?" And I was like, "I don't know, probably not." She's like, "How about a dollar for the whole box?" And I said, "Well, for a dollar, I'll take them." Thinking if I could get, 30 bucks for the whole of them, even 25, I could probably make money with free mini mail shipping. But sold them for 40. Ended up costing, I think, $9 to ship them. So not too bad there. One of my best sale of the month, Garmin Fish Finder, paid 30 bucks. It was brand new. Guy on OfferUp had this. He had bought it for his boat and then realized he needed a better fish finder, so he went out and bought a new one. His wife told him to sell this one to make money, and he sold it to me for 30 bucks, and I sold it for 150. So that was pretty awesome, and I'm definitely on the lookout for fish finders in the future, and I recommend you guys should as well. Crockpot lid, 23 bucks. This goes to a Rival crockpot. It's a plastic lid. I don't mess around with the Rival glass lids. My wife had sold one on her eBay, but we're not going to sell those anymore. Too much of a hassle to pack them. They weigh too much. These plastic lids, you could bubble wrap them and they'll still be first class. So that's pretty good. Mortal Kombat, $11 there. Baseball Stars, $12. Another Cuisinart, a different one, but $9 for that blade. This is like a little needle craft. It's like a bear that you can make. I paid 3 bucks, sold it for 15. Got good feedback, so that was awesome. Kingdom Hearts, these ones always sell pretty well. Ended up selling these for $22. Britney Spears, pardon for the more promiscuous attire she's wearing. Sorry, my cat's getting in the way again. So if you're younger, hopefully you don't look at that. We'll just skip this or pause the video for a second and scroll to a little bit further on, but got this for $2 at a Goodwill. Bought this one, another Britney Spears shirt. Someone had offered me 20 on this. I had countered with 30. I had it listed at 40. I'm hoping they'd go 25 and I would have sold it. They declined right away. They were only going to pay 20. I was like, oh man, maybe I should have sold it. Only paid 2 bucks. $20 is pretty good for a $2 shirt. Next day, someone paid full price, $40 for this. So this particular one, someone had sold for 30 before. And there weren't, I think, any other that had sold recently. So I got even higher than he did, but no complaints there. A little gift box here, paid $2 for this and sold it for, or $3 and sold it for 27. Pac-Man game for 15. Bearcat scanner. This one actually had an issue. It was trying to connect the channels, but they weren't coming through that well. It has an antenna. So I listed it kind of for repair and got 27. If it worked, it's probably more like a $45, $50 unit, something like that. Maybe 40, but still pretty good considering I had paid, I think, 3 bucks for it. Another Polaroid for 28. Super Smash Brothers for 18. Another fish finder, the second one I bought, paid 20 for this one and sold it for 115. This one was actually new in the package. So these parts were open, the rest were still bagged, and this thing hadn't been used yet. The box is just horrible. It's all like yellowing and stuff from storage, but everything else is in great shape. So it appears that it was unused. Reebok, don't usually buy Reebok golf polos. They're not too desirable, but when it's a 4XL, I had paid $4.99 for this and I sold it for $25. So just the size on that one's why I picked it up. These are a bunch of stuff. When I had sold that Breyer horse doll, I also found a bunch of this stuff in there, just miscellaneous fences and little corrals and jump things. Sold that for 20 bucks just to make a little extra money. Wii Sports, really good game, sells well. $11 for that. Another pair of BK jeans, $27 there. Also paid 5. Another video game for 12. Cool. And these are cool, but the brand is actually KUHL Cool. Remember this brand. Look it up. These things sell super well. It's more of like an outdoorsy, oops, sorry, hiking brand. I recommend buying these. I had paid $7, I think, for these. Seven, maybe $6.50 for these. I sold them for 50 bucks. Got good feedback. I have another pair. It just has a little stain on it that I can't get out. This cat is just getting in the way. But I still hope they'll get 40 for those 35 worst case. But cool, they make a lot of hiking pants and shorts, and you also can find jackets and shirts for them. Just remember that brand if you're a clothing seller, it does really well. Power Rangers, 15 bucks. Another food processor part for 8. Another game for 16, Thunder Spirits. This was a Panasonic little cassette player recorder I bought. It did not work, could not get it to work at all, even with fresh batteries and everything. Sold it for parts for 15. I only paid like a dollar for it, so that wasn't too bad. Nest thermostat, paid $35 for this. The lady never used it. There was a slight little tear in the seal right here, but it obviously had never been opened. Paid $35, sold it for $100. Breg, they make Polar Care, like the little systems where it's like a little cooler with ice and water, and it pumps it around your knee and cools off if you've had knee surgery or something. So 20, that unit didn't have all the pieces, so I parted it out, got 20 for the power cord. Another game for 12, some books for 10, Pioneer Girls. These are older, kind of Christian-themed books, and that was something I bought a long time ago. There's a video about it somewhere, but finally sold those. This is the For Real Butterscotch, the For Real Pony. It's a big pony. I've also had this in some of my videos. I buy them. Usually they're broken when I buy them, like something's wrong with the neck. But I always sell these battery covers for at least 40. I got 44 for this one. So this is a battery cover holder. You put the batteries in and then snap it into the unit. So that's pretty good. Another game. You see the label's all jacked up, but don't be discouraged. Even that, depending on what the game is, you can still sell. $17. Super Tennis, $7. Bought this a long time ago for $6. I don't know why I bought it. I guess I bought it because I knew one day it was going to sell, but paid $6. Had it listed for 49. I listed for all different kinds of prices. Finally, someone bought it for $50 on like Friday, and so they needed it by Wednesday, and wanted to make sure it arrived by Wednesday. I was like, "Are you kidding me? You're in New York, and I'm in California. You can't just put that on me." But I packed it up and ended up shipping it priority to them for like $20. I paid a little bit extra just because honestly I wanted to get rid of it. So I paid priority $20. So I probably made 15 out of it. But she got it. It was for a birthday party. They needed this for a birthday party for some little girl. So I was happy. I don't think it's kind of ugly looking, but obviously some people like this kind of thing. I'm not a art or any kind of buyer like that, so it wasn't anyone famous. I think it was just some work done by just an average person. So, but did sell it, made some money, and the person was happy, so that was cool. Altoid tins, empty ones. Got these from my friend at work. He's a fiend when it comes to Altoids, but he gave me all these. Excuse me, and I ended up selling them for $25. Arizona Wildcats, paid a dollar for this at a garage sale. Jersey, sold it for 15. Another Cuisinart. This is the stem, $8. Another Cuisinart piece. That's $12 for the lid. Raising emotionally and socially healthy kids. Everyone probably needs this. This one was brand new. Bought it at an estate sale for a dollar. Sold it for 35. It was actually sealed with the book and the DVD. These Great Courses ones, look out for those. The VHS ones, not so much. The DVD ones or the CD ones, they can be worth money. So, just ask. These books do really well. Mine were actually kind of messed up with some water damage on some of them. So I had paid $7 for all these. Didn't realize that some of them had the damage. I got 25, so I made money on them. But if you get a lot that's in great shape, you can probably get more like 30 or $40. So, Scrabble. $35. This is one of the deluxe, or this is a collector's edition one. Usually ships for 10. I don't pay more than 5 for these. Another PS2 game for 16. University of Tennessee hat for 12. Jeep Comanche hat for 20. So plain, not sure why someone even bought that, but we'll take it. King of Fighters. These I took a best offer these for $30, and they sold, so that was cool to get rid of those. Little DVD that I had came with that Walking Dead one. Got $8 for that. This is a Irish type, newsman type hat or whatever. Got it for seven. Sold it for 17. I think I paid $2 or $3. Jungle Book for 7. Almost. This is the last one, guys. Black & Decker Handy Steamer, paid $10 on a Facebook Marketplace deal. It was brand new in the box. Everything was still sealed. The box was open though, so I had to sell it as open box. Sold it in one day for $70. So that's it, guys. 35 minutes. Hopefully that's not too long. I see people on YouTube posting videos that are like an hour and a half, 2 hours long. I know you probably could spend more time talking about some of this stuff, but that's just too long. I don't think anyone's going to want to sit there and watch a video for that long. So hopefully, I'm trying to keep them under 40 with all the sales. Hopefully, you guys are getting some out of it. If you want me to cut out some sales, if you want me to cut out ones that are under 10, if anyone has any advice on that, I'll definitely listen to it and see if it, is something that multiple people want. I do like to show you the realistic side of selling, though, that not everything is going to sell for 70. I also like to show you the returns and stuff too, because that's part of the business and you can't really get frustrated with it because things are just going to happen sometimes. But hope you enjoy. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I will say that I have an Instagram now that I'm doing for eBay stuff, more so just to show some stuff to people that I might not have in my videos or maybe out and about showing you stuff. So if you guys, it's in my, the description of the video. It'll be there. If you guys want to subscribe, please feel free to do so. And I hope you guys have a great day.